Hey everyone, for those just tuning in, I'm Benji Yang, product manager here at Shopify. In this video, I'll be walking you through bidding and optimization. Before we get started, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel to get the latest insights on building with Shopify. In this section on bidding and optimization, I want to cover what constitutes optimizing your account essentially. And I also want to cover the differences between Shopify App Store ads and what most other search platforms are like as far as their auction process. So first, let's cover the auction process because it's a relatively short and simple one. Shopify App Store ads operates on a first price auction. So in other words, buyers actually pay the actual bid that they put down for any given keyword. Unlike a second price auction, which is what Google and Bing operate on, actually most search ads platforms operate on, where you pay the bid for the second place competitor. So this is important to keep in mind as it can alter your bidding strategies. One thing that I used to do for Google and Bing was for high performing keywords, I would often set really high bids, knowing that they would often not reach those levels. This is something that you don't want to do on Shopify App Store ads. You want to make sure that you're comfortable paying the price that you're bidding. Which leads us to optimizing and bidding. Just to set goals for optimization, what it means, it's very similar to the grouping of keywords and account structure. Optimization is ensuring that you're bidding on the right keywords and acquiring installs at the most optimal price. One thing that you should be doing from the beginning is to track your historic performance. So in other words, you want to get an idea of what the range is for your cost per install over time. So on the low end, you should know that your cost per install is something like 60 cents. On the high end, you want to know that your cost per install is something like $1.50 or something like that. You also want to know where your average is, just so you have an idea of whether you're performing above or below your historical average. And then we get to sort of what optimization means. It's similar to the previous video in that you want to ensure your budget is spent where you get the greatest return. So we talked about in the previous video about how to group your keywords into ads for the greatest return. Now we'll be looking at specifically how to adjust your bids and how to adjust your bids or even which keywords you should be bidding on for optimal performance. And a key is to know, one of the things to look for is when you should optimize, I guess. The answer is you should be optimizing all the time. You want to constantly be keeping in the back of your mind what your historical performance has been like, so historical range as well as your average, and where the keywords are relative to that historical norms. And I'll use this campaign, or I'll use this ad as an example right here. For this one right here, I can see that, so I've sorted these by install, which is what I typically like to do, as I want to know which keywords are driving the most impact to the ad overall. And as you can see here, the highest performing keywords are the exact match keywords, and then you have the broad match keywords a little bit lower down the list. With this in mind, you want to look at, say, for example, product reviews. This particular keyword doesn't generate the most installs, but on a cost per install basis, this is the best performing keyword. So what this tells me is that I want to be appearing for this keyword, auctions for this keyword, more often wherever I can. The best way to do that is to increase your bid. You look at your average position, and if you have not such great average position, so if your average position is something like 2 or 3, there's room to improve, or even 4, there's room to improve on this. And the room to improve is to increase your bid and increase your visibility. So in this example, the bid is not really the constraint, given that my average position is 1, and there's no greater visibility I can essentially get by increasing my bid. For this particular optimization, is probably not what I want to do, but what I can do with this, so in this specific instance, is I'll probably want to isolate this particular keyword, or maybe this one and reviews as a keyword. I want to isolate these and maybe just create standalone ads with just these two so that they can continue to run with as much budget as I'm willing to put behind them. And that's part of the optimization, is not only knowing when to adjust your bids up or down, but also knowing which keywords you need to let run so that you can generate the greatest returns. Like if this performance is what I was seeing on my ad and it was constantly running out of budget and you're getting the limited by budget indicator all the time, what I might do is I might just start systematically turning off keywords so that I can get more action, I can oxygenate these with more budget to acquire more installs at the cost per install that these two are driving. And that sort of sums up optimization within an ad. So look at what performance is for your keyword list, which keywords are driving the best performance at the highest volume of installs. If your average position or your visibility are low and you think there's room to improve, increasing the bid can do this. If you increase the bid, just make sure you keep eyes on this to make sure that it has the desired effect for you and that you're getting the expected outcome here. So, for example, if your average position is increasing, your bid is increasing, your cost per click is increasing, but the volume of installs or the cost per install is not performing according to your expectations, maybe it's time to start adjusting down for that. The other way to optimize is to allocate more budget to any given keywords. So, for example, if these two are the ones that I really want most of my budget to flow to, you have two options. You can create a new ad just with these two and then turn them off in this one so that you're not bidding against yourself. Or what you can do is in this particular ad, turn off everything else so that these two keywords get the most budget that you've allocated to them. Another way that you can optimize actually is on broad match keywords. So as we mentioned before, broad match keywords can match to multiple search terms, including ones that are not exactly the same as the keyword itself. And in this particular case, we can sort by match type here, and you can see that it gives me a number of installs, cost per install. So what you want to do here is you want to pull out the search term for that broad match keyword, and you maybe want to add it to the ad itself, or you want to create a new ad with just high-performing search terms. So in this instance, I probably want to look at. So I want to add looks review, and $1.05 is pretty good. 16. So I want to add these two as keywords because right now I'm only participating in auctions through the broad match keyword, which is matching to a whole bunch of different things. And instead, I want to increase my focus on what's performing really well. So I will add these as keywords. Actually, looks review cannot be added because it's a restricted keyword, right? There is a trademark against that on that keyword, and so we're not able to bid on that, but product I can. So I will add this as an exact match keyword, click save, and it'll be added to the ad as an exact match keyword so that you're bidding exclusively only on that one right there. That is another way that you can optimize your ads. And then once it's been added and you have some performance history, we kind of do the same thing that we did a little bit earlier, where we looked at whether or not there's room to increase the bid or whether or not we should be shutting off other keywords to focus budget on those that are performing well. Thanks for tuning in to Bidding and Optimization. I hope you found the video helpful. Of course, please don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel to get the latest updates on products and tools.